Good morning. I am Lakshmi Shanmugam. I am an Eclipse platform committer and co-lead, and I work for IBM India. Today I am going to talk about how to make your Eclipse application HiDPI ready. So the agenda for the session would be an introduction to HiDPI, and I'll talk about auto-scaling and look at the steps which are required to make your application HiDPI ready. And in the end, we will look at what to expect in the coming releases in terms of HiDPI support.
It's your ear
okay,
on this side.
Okay.
Maybe if you can take this out, yeah, it's cool. Thank you very much.
Okay, so what is HiDPI? DPI stands for dots per inch. And in the context of displays, it actually means PPI, which is pixels per inch. It's a measure of the pixel density of the display. So the pixel density, or DPI, you can say, is measured based on the size of the display and the number of pixels in the horizontal and in the vertical directions. So for example, if you look at this image, you can see that the first square has only one pixel. The second has 2 pixels in the horizontal and vertical direction, so it will be 2 DPI. The next has 5 pixels, and so on and so forth. We have 100 DPI. So the last one has 100 pixels in the horizontal and vertical direction in a square inch. So traditionally, Windows has been using a standard DPI. Windows and Linux has been using a standard DPI of 96, and Mac uses a standard DPI of 72. And so high DPI actually means high DPI or high PPI, which is high pixel density. So high DPI displays, so you can see the difference between standard DPI, standard resolution displays, and high resolution displays. So there are less pixels in the in the standard resolution displays. The pixels are larger in size, they are more sparsely placed. While in a high density display, there are more pixels, but the pixels are smaller in size and they are more closely packed. So if you look at the DPIs of some of the popular displays, these are all high DPIs. You can see how in the middle you can see the formula which is being used to calculate the DPI or the PPI, and you can see that the retina monitors have DPIs around 200 to 220, and we also have monitors with DPI of 441. Okay, so why all the hype about high DPI? Why everybody wants to have a high DPI display now? Let us look at this image to understand. So if you look at the first image, which is being rendered at 96 PPI, you can see this is actually zoom, a version of the image. You can see that the image is not very clear, it's very blurred, and also the image is very pixelated. At 192 DPI, it is much better. The text is sharper and the image is also better, but you can still see the blurriness in the corner. At 384 DPI, you can see that both the text and image is very clear, and there are more details actually visible in the image. So what it means is that in a high DPI display, it increases the clarity or the sharpness of the UI elements, basically provides a rich visual experience to the users. So the text, the controls, the drawing, everything is much sharper. So let's understand why the drawing is sharper in high resolution. So if you look at the image on the left, it is on a drawing on a standard resolution. You can see there are less pixels available to draw the shape of the curve or to approximate the shape of the curve, but at a high resolution display, there are more pixels available. Hence, you have more pixels which are more closely packed available to draw a more approximate shape of the curve. So you can clearly see the difference that the left image is slightly jagged and blurry, but the right image is much sharper. So HiDPI is all good. So what is the problem? The problem is that all the code we have currently, the applications, they are not HiDPI ready. They were all written with the assumption of a standard resolution being 96 or 72, and they don't look good, they don't render well on a HiDPI monitor. So let's look at the problems we have. So increasing the DPI makes the UI element smaller. So what this means is that at 72 DPI or at 96 DPI, the pixels are larger in size, they are more sparsely placed, and the for example, this square is actually, it will be rendered at a larger size. But on a high DPI monitor, the pixels are more closely packed and they are smaller in size, and hence the image is also rendered much smaller. So what this actually means for applications is, if you have an icon which appears this size on at 100% zoom or on Windows, it would appear at this size at 200% zoom, which is almost 1/4 the size. So let us look at Eclipse. This is at standard resolution, all the images and the text looks okay for the resolution at which it is being displayed. At a high DPI monitor, you can see multiple problems. So you can see all the icons in the toolbar are much smaller in size. The icons in the package explorer are also small, whereas the text is much bigger. So they are not proportional to the text as well. On Mac, the problem is slightly different. So Mac OS is much smarter. So what it does is, on Mac, it all the screen sizes are in points. It doesn't deal with pixels. Even applications only have to deal with points on Mac. And on the left, we have a standard resolution display, and on the right, we have a Retina display. And you can see that one pixel here is actually maps to 4 pixels on a Retina display. And when the application has to be rendered on a Retina display, Mac automatically takes care of scaling that particular object to the Retina display, and this makes sure that the object is of the same size whether it is being displayed on the standard resolution or the high resolution. So here Mac takes care of doing the scaling for you. Okay, though it does the scaling, there is one problem. So let us look at Eclipse to understand that. So here on the non-Retina screen, everything looks okay for the resolution at which it's being displayed. On the Retina screen, can you see the problem? So the text in the package explorer and also in the editor is very sharp, but the images in the toolbar and in the package explorer are blur. This is because OS is actually, Mac OS is scaling the icons, but as a result of this, it's making them blur. They appear blur. So this actually, so both the problems give a very poor user experience, and what we need is to make your application high DPI ready. So what we mean by that is your application should be DPI aware. It should be able to render correctly both on a standard resolution display and on a high resolution display. So what are the things required for that? The application should have resolution independent UI. The UI should not be dependent on the resolution, and it should support size invariance. What I mean by that is the UI elements should appear the same size whether they are being rendered on standard resolution or high resolution. And on a high DPI device, we expect users expect all the text, the drawing, the UI controls, all of them to appear sharp. So these are all the characteristics of a high DPI ready application. And how SWT helps here is it provides a platform independent high DPI support which hides all the platform differences and provides a common API or interface which the users can use. So SWT APIs make use of point geometry for display, graphics APIs, events, all of them make use of points. And due to this, users have to work only with points and they don't have to deal with the pixels. And the advantage of this is that the users have to deal only with points, but SWT internally takes care of making the OS calls either with pixels or points based on the platform on which it is being run. Okay, so let's quickly go into how to make your application HiDPI. So all you have to do is leverage the support which is being provided by Eclipse and SWT. So, okay, let me first talk about auto-scaling. So we already saw the auto-scaling which is being provided by macOS. Auto-scaling is basically automatic scaling of the UI elements. And this is required when you are trying to render image which is not at high resolution, but you're trying to render it on a high DPI monitor. So an automatic scaling is required so that it is rendered in the correct size or the expected size. And we already saw Mac provides this native auto scaling of images on retina displays. And text is, we also saw that text is automatically scaled by the OS on all the platforms. So what is missing? Scaling of images and layout on Windows and Linux, and this is what SWT provides. And this happens based on the zoom factor, and this support is available in Eclipse since Neon. So let us see auto scaling in action. So this is an older version of Eclipse. So we have without auto scaling, you can see we saw the problem, and with auto scaling, you can see that the icons in the package explorer have been scaled up so that they are of the same size as they would render at 100% zoom. But do you notice that the icons are actually blur? This is the same problem we saw on Mac. Auto scaling actually results of or fixes the size invariance problem, but it results in blur images. So I would say auto scaling is just a help which is being provided by SWT or by the OS on Mac till your application, till you make your application HiDPI ready, but it is not the solution. And the SWT's auto scaling can be tweaked using the Java property SWT auto scale. By default, it is integer 200. What it means is that the scaling is happens in integer multiples of 100 with a maximum scaling of 200. And if you want to turn it off, you can as well use false. Okay, let's quickly jump into the steps required to make your application HiDPI ready. The first one is for all the images which you have in your application, provide a high resolution version of the image as well. So Eclipse already provides support here. So if you make use of the image descriptor.create from URL to create your images, let me show you a quick code example. So this is an example where an image is being created using image descriptor create from URL. Then you already have support for HiDPI. You don't have to do anything in the code. But what you have to do is to provide a high resolution version of the image and name it with basically append the name with @2x and place it in the same location as the original image. And now Eclipse will make sure that when your application is being rendered on high DPI monitor, it will automatically pick up the high resolution version of the image. Okay, so a quick word about how the high resolution icons are generated for Eclipse itself. So we use the SVG image. So SVG images are available for all the icons. As you can see, SVG is very good at scaling. And from the SVG image, we generate the 1x and 2x PNG images. So if you are interested and want to try out how this is done, you can take a look at the Eclipse platform images Git repo, where we have all the images. And we also have the generator, which is used to generate the 1x and 2x PNG images. Okay, the next step is to create high DPI aware images in your code. So if you are using the SWT's constructors to create the images, then you have to start using the new SWT image constructors which create DPI aware images. So let me go to the example directly. So this is an these are examples of these are the image constructors which are available. So the first one uses image data, the second one uses input stream. So if you are using these APIs or these constructors to create the image is not DPI aware. So you need to replace them with the image constructor which uses the image data provider. The image data provider is an interface which needs to be implemented by the clients, and it provides a callback mechanism for the clients using which they can provide the image data at the required zoom level at which it has to be rendered. So what this means is when SWT is going to render an image at a particular zoom level, it will make a call to the image data provider's get image data method, and clients need to implement the get image data method to return the image data for the given zoom level. So you want an example to see this? So let's look at this. So here is a simple example where we are creating an image and setting it on the button. Here it uses the image data. So how the new code will look? The new code now uses the new constructor which uses the image data provider instead of the image data. And if you look at the implementation of image data provider, it's very simple. The get image data method, you just need to return the correct image data based on the zoom level. Okay, similarly for the image constructor which uses the file name, it has to be replaced with the constructor which uses the image file name provider. And similar to the image data provider, image file name provider is an interface which has to be implemented by the clients, and it provides a callback mechanism to get the correct image file path for the zoom level. And the get image path method will be called by SWT when the image has to be rendered, and clients need to implement it to return the image file path for the particular zoom level. A quick example here. So this example again creates the image using the image file path, and this code can be replaced by constructor which takes in the file name provider, and the implementation of file name provider is again as simple as the image data provider. You just need to return the correct file path based on the zoom level. Okay. So we have created the HiDPI aware images in the application. Next step is to use the HiDPI aware APIs to work with these images. Okay, so the most commonly used operation on images is to get the image data. So this API, the get image data API, will return the image data at 100% zoom level. We had added an API which will get image data at current zoom. And it is deprecated now because we realize that it doesn't make sense in an environment where we have multiple monitors connected with multiple monitors with different DPIs, because current zoom doesn't make sense when you have different monitors with different DPIs. So if you're using this API, you should stop using it. And we have a new API which is provided. This was provided in Oxygen, which is get image data of zoom, which basically returns the image data for a given zoom level. And this method is mainly intended to be used inside the implementations of the image data provider. If you want to do some composite drawing, or you want to draw some composite images based on the zoom level, you can use this. So let us look at an example of how it has been used in the Eclipse platform itself. So all of you are familiar with the breadcrumb view, and you can see there is a black arrow. You can see it's not being drawn correctly. So this is on a HiDPI monitor. This is how it used to look, not in 4.7. So it was not drawn correctly. Why? Let us look at the code. So if you look at the implementation of how the arrow was being drawn, we just use the image.getImageData to get the image data and then use that to draw the image. This will work correctly at 100% zoom, because getImageData returns the image data at 100% zoom, but doesn't work correctly when you are at 200% zoom, because getImageData is not returning the image data at 200% zoom. So how do we make it work for HiDPI monitors? Replace the getImageData call with the getImageData of zoom. And this is how you're going to modify it. Move the whole drawing code inside the image data provider's get image data method. And the difference, I have highlighted the difference here, that instead of calling get image data, you will now be calling get image data of Zoom. So actually, this results in passing or getting the correct image data for the Zoom level. So it will draw the image correctly at both 100% zoom and at 200% zoom. And you can see that now we are calling the draw image with the image data provider instead of it being called with image data. Okay, let's move on to image descriptors. I'm sure all of you are familiar with image descriptors. So both image descriptors and composite image descriptor classes are now fully HiDPI ready. What it means, so an image descriptor basically is an object which knows how to create SWT images. Let me go to the class directly. So using the image descriptor class, now you can create HiDPI aware images. So all the methods except for the ones which have been deprecated, all of them can be used to create HiDPI aware images. And what is the change which the subclasses need to do? Get image data has been deprecated, so now they have to start implementing get image data of Zoom. And please note, you have to implement only one of the methods and not both. Okay, similarly, we have the composite image descriptor. And composite image descriptor is again can be used to create HiDPI aware composite images. So if you look at it, it's an abstract class, and there are two abstract methods which the subclasses must implement. This is same as before, but what has changed is that the draw image of image data method has been deprecated. So in your draw composite, you will no longer call draw image of image data, but you will call draw image of image data provider. So let us look at an example here. This is your old code where you get the image data from the image descriptor and call draw image of image data. But the new code will look like this, where you create an image data provider and pass the image data provider in the draw image call. Okay, a word about decoration overlay icon. This is an image descriptor which is used to overlay the decoration images on the four quadrants of the base image. And this class does, if you're using this, clients of this class, they don't have to make any changes. They get HiDPI support for free. Okay, so with all these changes, this is how Eclipse looks. Eclipse is HiDPI ready, at least on Windows. This is what you see. You can see that all the icons are in the Package Explorer toolbar. All of them are sharp, they are not blurry, and also, okay, it doesn't look so good there, but it looks good on my screen. Okay, so the HiDPI support in Eclipse is not 100% complete. There are still some things which are still being worked upon. There are some bugs here and there. But there are two major things which are still in progress. So one is the dynamic resolution switching. So what this means is that, okay, there are two things to it. So first, you have your application open on the display, and the display is at a particular resolution, and you change it to a different resolution. You expect the application to render correctly at the new display or the new display settings. The second one is when you have multiple monitors connected and the monitors are at different displays, and you drag the application from one monitor to another. Again, the monitors are at different DPIs, so you expect the application to render correctly at the new resolution. So this is what we mean by dynamic resolution switching. And this works well on Mac. Again, we didn't have to do anything. It was provided, this is native support provided by Mac, so it works well. But there are problems on Windows and GTK. It's not yet supported by Eclipse. So the main problem is that Windows 7 and I think the older versions of Linux, they do not support having different DPIs at different DPIs for different monitors. On Windows 7, the other problem is if you change the DPI, you also need to log off and then log in. So the question of dynamic resolution switching doesn't come over there. But Windows 10 and the newer Linux OS would support different DPIs on connected monitors. So this is what we have to work on to provide support. Eclipse and SWT have to provide support for this. The other problem which we have is scaling of images which are drawn using GC on Mac. So this problem is very specific to Mac. For example, let me show you some images. So you can see these images are on a retina display, but you can see that the images are or the text is blurred. This is because they are drawn using GC. GC draws on the low resolution version of the image and OS is scaling that image. That is why it appears blurred. So what we need to do here is we have to actually draw on the high resolution version of the image and not draw on the low resolution version and let OS scale it. So what are the APIs proposed? So we are working on API to get DPI for each of the monitors, API to support DPI aware image drawing in GC. Okay, yeah, so that's it I had. I just wanted to show maybe Eclipse on Mac, how it looks. I don't think you can make out the difference, but yeah, it looks, all the images look very clear and sharp. Yeah, you cannot make out from there. So please sign in and vote for the session. Thank you. Sorry? 150. Actually, Windows provides support for that, but the scaling support provided by SWT, as I showed you, the SWT.autoscale. So let me show you this slide. So these are the arguments for SWT autoscale. So by default, we use integer 200. That is, we support only the zoom factors of 100 and 200. So 150 is not supported by default. But if you want to try 150, you can use exact or you can use value. But the main reason we don't support it is because on Windows we have problems with fractional scaling, where when you try to scale, it doesn't scale properly. So that was the reason it is being disabled. But if you want to play around or experiment, you can use this. But yeah, you should be aware of the problems which you would face. Any questions? Okay, thank you.